Muskegon Museum of Art is a gem for this community, providing all kinds of opportunities almost for everyone in terms of a cultural experience, a learning experience, or a fun experience.
The museum is a special place, as you may know. We have some of the world's greatest art in Muskegon, and we're blessed to have it. You know, the history is really more than 100 years old, and we want to keep it for the next generation and the generation after that as well.
My grandfather was a custodian here when I was a young child, but I was brought on the board to be in a leadership role to help the organization and got the wonderful opportunity to learn to appreciate and enjoy the artworks that we have here. But there's bottom line benefit from recruiting and retention of people for businesses, and also the educational value of what's provided here, both to adults and to children. People come from all over the country, sometimes all over the world, to see what we have here.
Yes, it brings in people, it brings in money, and it enhances our economy, and it also makes us a great place to live.
Over the past 108 years, the Muskegon Museum of Art has been assembling one of the finest permanent collections of art anywhere in the Midwest. We have a collection that's usually only found in the big cities, New York and Chicago and Detroit. For example, the Edward Hopper, it's one of our masterpieces. It is the only original Edward Hopper painting that you're able to see in the entire state of Michigan. Our artwork is in demand from other museums across the country and the world. So we regularly lend artworks to cities such as Madrid, Paris, Munich, Washington, D.C., New York City, etc. And people may not be aware, but given the current footprint of the building, we're only able to exhibit 3% of the collection at any one time. We need to move the collection from the preserve storage and bring it into public purview. And the only way we can do that is to enlarge our gallery space.
This expansion is about 20 years in the making. After we acquired the Medical Arts Building and converted that and Second Street into parking lots, the board decided they needed to raise an endowment so we could separate from the school system. And these are all little steps. The end game has always been for expansion because, simply put, we are just out of space. Our vault is crammed. Every time we do something here, it's like doing a little bit of a Tetris game where we have to move this, move that to get something out. So this will make actually functioning a lot easier. But it's really a modest expansion. A couple of classrooms, some community space, with a combination of three simple galleries and turning the old museum totally over to permanent collection. We have about 5,300 pieces in the collection. And on a good day, we can show maybe 125. And at the rate we rotate this collection, it would take over 40 years for us to show the entire collection. So there's a huge need for extra permanent collection space. And we can't do that at the expense of our rotating exhibitions because that's what brings people in. We have a major glass collection. We have a major print collection. We have a lot of sculpture. We have a major Japanese art collection that we just can't show. And to have those up permanently, that'll drive a lot of people to the museum. Our attendance will increase, membership will increase. We can transform into a destination museum.
How do we share all of this? How do we share this big collection of studio glass, which really requires a different kind of theatricality to its presentation? We are really looking to try to give that big visual experience with what we're having out and what we're doing, and so there's something for everyone at any given moment. But also we're looking at the expansion as a place to add an activity area, a place that is dedicated to people being able to come in and try their hand at the art, to have that direct, engaged experience that I think all museums are looking at as we continue to blur the lines between education and entertainment and that enduring interest in the visual arts. The expansion is really going to let us do that. It's going to let us bring that to West Michigan.
I think that the expansion is going to offer so many accessibility proponents to the museum, as well as so many more opportunities for students and for families and for young adults and for mature adults to be able to come into this space and experience it in a grand new way. So our classroom right now is pretty narrow and it's really small. It wasn't initially designed to be a classroom, so having a wider space, having a space that's a little bit more inviting and just all around bigger, would really benefit the educational space, because even when there isn't like a formal program going on, having like a drop-in space for students to come and participate in, or families to come into so they can experience a hands-on approach before they enter the galleries, would be super beneficial.
Right now the trend is, and what's popular, we know we can do giant exhibitions. Curtis was a experiment in that in some ways, but to rent big tourist type shows for the summer, we just don't have the capacity. Our largest gallery, the Walker Gallery, just doesn't hold the space. So part of the expansion of the three galleries is one to have a giant 5,000 square foot rotating space, which we can bring in those large exhibitions that would be popular for everyone.
Some of the exhibits are very, very, very expensive exhibits, but they reach people in other countries. Come here and sign in. And I want to say the Curtis was a great example of that. People came from everywhere.
You know, in a lot of ways, the cultural institutions are in the entertainment industry. And you have to respond to what is happening today in the entertainment industry. You know, a 1912 Museum of Art doesn't serve the needs of artists and exhibitions that we have today.
In my opinion, art is to be appreciated, viewed, respected, studied, enjoyed. We are the caretakers of this important collection. We need to preserve it for future generations. And we need to make sure it exists in the public sphere.